Well, as I said earlier, today is a special celebratory day, not only because it's Palm Sunday, but in a moment here, we're going to have some people, through the act of baptism, demonstrate their decision to follow Jesus with their whole life, mind, body, and soul, and strength. But today is a day when we remember that on that first Palm Sunday that Jesus rode in on that donkey's colt to shouts of acclamation, shouts of Hosanna, and people around gathered around that they waved and they celebrated Jesus as King. And as we think about Jesus in our own life, we need to think about Jesus not simply as our Savior, not just simply as our Lord, but as our King, that He's come to be reigning King and to reign currently, and that we submit our lives, our whole lives, under His kingship. During His life and His ministry and His teaching, Jesus had some special words to say to His disciples. And then after His death and resurrection, He gave some directives, some commands, if you will, to the early church and to His first fledgling group of disciples and what that would look like. And this is what He says in Matthew chapter 28, where He says this: "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I've commanded you. And surely I'm with you always to the very end of the age." What Jesus is saying here in this last part of His earthly life before He is ascended back into heaven to reign and to rule from there, what He's telling us as His followers of Jesus is that we are to prioritize our going and making disciples of people. In other words, to help other people to align their life with the teachings of Jesus, in our language at Crossroads, to help people to become an apprentice to Jesus, learning to live our life in the way Jesus would live our life if He were living our life. This is what it means to when Jesus says, go and make disciples of all nations. And when someone aligns their life with Jesus and they kind of submit themselves to King Jesus, then we are to baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Some people think about baptism, they think about that baptism is a way in which you get cleaned from the sin, the way in which you can cleanse yourself from the unrighteousness, the difficulty of the bad things that are going on in your life. But it's more than that. It has a much of symbolism to that, but it's such much more than that. Really, what baptism is a decision to be identified with the work and the person of Christ. And so what you will see this morning, as some already have done at the first service, what you will see this morning is when people go into the baptismal waters just behind me, when they go into the waters, what you'll see is people identifying with the work of Jesus. That when they walk into the waters, they recognize that they're walking towards Christ. And as they go down under the water, they're dying to their own self. They're putting to death their ways of doing things to be raised to new life in Christ. It's an outward expression of an inward decision. Our hearts decide to follow Jesus, and outwardly we are to proclaim that to those around us. We are to tell people with our words. We're to tell people with our lifestyle and our decisions, our values, our ethics, and how we orient our life. And we're to tell people by the symbolism of baptism. It's an important step of obedience that each follower of Jesus are to take in their life as we follow Christ, as we begin this journey of apprenticeship, of learning to do what Jesus would do if He were living our life. And so today is a celebratory day. And you get a chance to be a part of that celebration. Again, not just because of Palm Sunday, but because of these decisions, these people have made a decision to make public their decision to follow Christ with their whole life. I'm going to list off the names of the people that have decided to be baptized. And we had a little curveball thrown at us over the last week or so. We started with about 11 people that wanted to be baptized this weekend. And then COVID hit. And a couple of people couldn't make it. And then even this morning, a couple of people called in and said, hey, we're not feeling so good today. And so we're praying that they'd be feeling better. We'll be doing another one of these baptism services in the summer. But as these people come forward, as I read your name, and I didn't be able to catch up with everybody, so hopefully you're here, but you can come up front and as I read your name. And as they come forward, as you think about if you're someone who's a follower of Jesus and you have been baptized, when you see these people go into the waters, I want you to remember your baptism and remember what it was like when you made public for all to see your decision to follow Jesus with your life. And if you're a follower of Jesus and you've never been baptized, then I'd ask you to give some consideration to what does it look like to make public your decision to follow Jesus, to not stay secretive about your decision to have him be the king of your life. But if you're a follower of Jesus and you've not yet made the decision to make public that declaration, I'd ask you to give some consideration to doing that at one of our future baptism services this summer, perhaps. And we go from there. Jesus tells us to do this. It's an important thing that we do, and we do it on a regular basis. It's actually one of my absolute favorite things we do as a church family, because it's not just for these individuals, but it's also for us as a fellowship to remember that they're being baptized into the identity with Christ and into this fellowship to where they can follow Christ together with us in this way. So again, I'm going to list all the names of people this weekend, so some from the earlier service, but if you hear your name and you're being baptized, I'd invite you to come and just kind of stand with me. But Kyle and Jessica, Jackson and Samuel, Melanie, Brittany, Shay, Kinley, and Kayla. So if you heard your name, come on up forward here. No one's moving. There we go. I was like, you're making me nervous. No one's going, okay, come on up. Come on up. All right, just gather right up around here. There we go, there we go. Awesome, come on up. All right, very good. Well, this is a crucial point in these people's lives where, again, where we can stand with them as a church family and celebrate with them. And in a moment, we'll hear some of their stories on the video while we kind of get ourselves ready and get ready to go into the waters, and we'll go from there. And then as you see them taking this profession and this declaration, this step, to celebrate with them, and let's proclaim that really loud and go from there. Right? So if you would, just where you're seated right there, if you would just extend a hand, and if you're online, if you would do the same thing with us as well. It's just one way for us to pray a blessing over these individuals and their decision to follow Jesus. So let's pray together, and then we'll kind of slide over this direction and get ready to go get in the waters and be baptized. So let's pray. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray for these individuals and the ones at the earlier service. We're grateful that you have called us into this fellowship, into this time to hear what you're doing in their life. And so, Lord, we just pray a special blessing over them today, that they would receive your goodness, your grace, and your mercy in their life, that they would follow hard after you for their whole lives. Father, we're grateful that you get to that we get to be a part of their life with them. It's in your name we pray. Amen. All right, let's head off this direction, and we'll get ready for it.
Hi, my name is Kelly Geisa, and I accepted Jesus into my life when I was 4 years old, and I've done a lot of bad things in my life, and I want to do better things in my life, and I don't want to be alone, and that's why I want to get baptized.
I'm Kayla Vermillion, and I want to be baptized because I'm excited to know Jesus.
Hello, my name is Samuel Clevenger, and I love Jesus because he died on the cross for me, and doing that, he shows a lot of love for me. And I want to grow a stronger relationship with God by getting baptized. And I want to show others that I am a follower of Christ.
I can still see steeple, a little church on the hill. There's a line at the altar. Every pew had been filled. The choir singing old hymns. There was peace in the valley as a preacher man said, in the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the Spirit, I'm washed by the blood, I'm buried with Christ, raised in new life, baptized.
Melanie Taylor. I've been attending Crossroads Church since I was a baby. I was baptized many years ago as a teenager at a revival at the fairgrounds. It has never felt right in my heart that I was not baptized in my church that I've attended all my life, with Easter being my favorite time of the year because it was then that Christ died for our sins. I would like to take this special time to make things right with my soul and to be baptized in my church.
My name is Brittany Taylor. I have been crossroads with my husband and two boys. I want to get baptized to grow my relationship with Jesus. I want to set a good example for my two boys. My relationship with Jesus is personal, but not private, and that's why I want to share it with you all today.
I can still hear the summer. All the people said amen. There was a gift to salvation, and you could be born again. I remember the power of the Lord as the Holy Spirit rushed in. There was peace like a river. Oh, and the preacher man said, in the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the Spirit, you're washed by the blood.
To get baptized this week because we were all in a really dark place before we found God, and now that we've started following Him, things have turned around for us. We've started seeing a lot of good in it, and it's just changed our lives.
Hi, I'm Shaylin Armstead, and I'm 9 years old, and I want to get baptized because I want to share my relationship with Him, and He's died on the cross for me. He changed my life. He taught me how to do better stuff when I did them wrong. He helped me on my homework. He helped me with problems I had. And my sister is going to be with me while I get baptized because she's the very first one who taught me Jesus and God.
I can still see the steeple, a little church on.
All right, we're going to start. Melanie, come on in. Woo! Okay.
Is it cold?
It'll warm up, I'm sure. All right. Well, just one step over there, so you just turn right here. There you go. There you go. Okay. All right, turn this way. Face everybody out that way. All right. Melanie, based on your profession of faith in Jesus Christ, as your Lord and Savior, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Hold my hand. I'll go right back this way. You good? Brittany, based on your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, We baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Just come right down here. There you go. Shay? Come on, Shay. You're going to come right on the side. Everybody see you?
Oh, yeah. I see you.
Shay, everybody? All right, Shay. Based on your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Hold my hands. Go right down. Right down. Kinley? Come on, Kinley. Come on the side of me. Everybody see you? Oh, yeah, you're good. Here we see it. This is Kinley. Everybody? All right, Kinley, ready? Mm-hmm. Based on your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Hold my hand. Let's go right now. Here you go. And Kayla. Warm. It's perfect. Kayla, I gotta do to you too. You don't see it? It's too high?
It's too high.
Oh! Too much fun. All right, Kayla. Based on your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Hold my hand. Let's go right now. Good job. Let me pray for us as we continue. Jesus, we're grateful that you have led these people and many others to follow you. And for the many that are here among us and watching online that are a part of this church family and family of these people, Lord, I pray that you would help us to follow you deeply with all of our life, that our life would be fruitful, faithful, and that we would be transformed into your image. It's in your name we pray. Amen.